is out of the woodwork. Our guest today writes a column in Worth magazine designed to help Generation Xers sort out the stock market. He's Ken Kersen, also editor of Green Newsletter for the Green Investor. And Ken, welcome to Business Day. Generation Xers, basically, Ken, are people in their 20s and maybe early 30s at this point, right?
Exactly.
How do they compare with, shall we say, the nice euphemism I think I used before was more experienced investors. That would be older people of my generation.
Well, I think people in Generation X, to use an overused term, feel that the Social Security system is by no means guaranteed to be around by the time they retire, that working for one corporation for their entire career is basically a thing of the past. And that self-directed retirement plans, 401ks and IRAs, are really mandatory now. They're not just some newfangled option. They're something that absolutely
So you're telling me that basically these people are paying attention to their retirement, saving for their retirement at a younger age than we baby boomers did.
That's right. People are being, they have to. They've seen their parents think that things were going to be around and then maybe get laid off at age 50 or something like that, and reduced expectations throughout the generation has led them to believe that they better look out for themselves because nobody else will.
Give me a rough idea, if you would, what the savings rate looks like for Generation Xers in really rough terms compared to what baby boomers were doing at a comparable age.
Well, Kemper Financial Services did a nice sort of survey with the Roper organization, and Generation Xers, even though they tend to earn less adjusted for inflation than baby boomers fresh out of college, are actually saving a greater percentage of their income, and that's why I started my newsletters. People know they have to do something and they really need some instruction as to where to go.
What are these people doing with it?
Well, stock mutual funds are pretty aggressive investors, which is good because being young, they have the time horizon that can ride out inevitable dips. They're getting into stock mutual funds, bond mutual funds, and there's just an incredible interest in technological companies, you know, the high-flying internet companies and things
Something
like that.
Something Generation Xers presumably understand. A question for you. You mentioned that because of their long time horizons, they could ride out a dip in the markets. Do they, in fact, know that? I mean, how many of these people remember back to the crash of 87?
Yeah, that would be the latest real example of a trying time, and I'm very interested to see how people my age.
Well, some of us are more than interested. Okay.
Yeah.
Because that flow of money into the stock market presumably has been part of the reason that stocks have done so well.
Yeah, I agree that that's a big part of the reason. And there have been a couple of recent trying things, crisis in Mexico, and other things that made it look like the economy was weak and the money kept flowing in. So I'm confident that most Generation X, as most investors in general, will believe that over the long haul, stocks pay off best of any investment class, and will hopefully not flee and do other profit taking at the first sign of trouble.
We have just 2 seconds left. Real quickly, Generation Xers, any idea of how much of the flow into the stock market they account for?
Not a big percentage. It's a tiny amount because their income is small, but it's bigger than generations before them.
But as we all know, prices are set at the margin. Ken Kersen, personal finance editor, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.